my brothers, pastors, and priests.
Abafundisi.
The elders.
Ama elder.
Madam Togo.
Mam Togo.
We love her so much. She comes to Kenya accompanying the woman of God. And I don't know why here she sits behind. In Kenya she sits right behind. So I was looking for her, but she needs to be right here in front. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So we thank God for all of you. Why can't we just appreciate the Lord for yourself? Amen.
Chapter 12.
I'm gonna do it in very few minutes and then I hand over the mic to the
bishop. James Uzwana.
Exodus chapter 12. We have had a great time since on track. For yesterday, it was just special for yesterday. In the evening session. But for this morning, I'm coming back to the season. Because there's something special that God has for us. And I believe that your life will never be the same. I'll try to take it slow again.
Just for the
sake of my Pastor Twala here, the interpreter, for him to be able to capture first the introduction part. Then maybe later we can now do the preaching. Amen. Exodus 12. We're going to read from verse 1. I still believe that we love the word. I don't think Ebenezer family has a problem with reading scriptures. So we're going to be together and be able to follow it. The Lord said to Moses, I'm reading from Amplified. The Lord said to Moses and Aaron in the land of Egypt, this month shall be the beginning of months to you. It is to be the first month of the year to you.
UJehova wayesekhuluma kuMose na-Aaron ezweni laseGibhithe ethi, le nyanga yakuba kini inhloko yezinyanga, ibe yinyanga yokuqala eminyakeni kini.
Let's first of all agree that this was is talking about the month of Abib.
Asikalivumelane ukuthi le Bible elikhuluma ngenyanga ebizwa ukuthi Abib.
And the Abib means April.
The nyanga Abib, it has to April.
So in the Jewish calendar, the beginning of the month, according to the word of the Lord, to Moses, was in this month of April.
Ngokwe calendar ya Majuda, uqala inyanga yokuqala ke ile nyanga ngokuktshela kwa Mose inyanga ka April.
So we are in that month of Abib. Which God said to Moses to tell the children of Israel, it will be the beginning of the month. So let's go verse 3. It says, tell all the congregation of Israel, on the 10th day of this month, the month of Abib, which is the beginning of the month, they are to take a lamb or young goat
for themselves
according to the size of the household of which he is the father, a lamb or a young goat for each household.
Khulumani kuyinhlangano yonke yakwa-Israyeli nithi, ngoleshumi lalenyanga, yilowo nalowo makazithathele iwundlu ngokwezindlu zawoyise, kube yiwundlu ngendlu.
Again, let's be able to see from that scripture that every household was required. It was a requirement that every household should have a lamb for each household. So it was a lamb for every house. A lamb for every house. Verse 5, we'll jump verse 4, we go to verse 5. It says, your lamb or young goat shall be perfect without blemish or bodily defect, a male year old, you may take it from the sheep or from the goats.
Iwondle mangabe nasi libe ngeleduna libe nomnyaka munye nilithathe nilithathe ezimvini noma ezimbuzini.
So it was in that same month of Abib, the 10th day, they shall take for themselves a lamb.
Ukuyilolo suku kolwenyanga yokuqala ke eyayibizwa ukuthi Abib ngosuku lweshumi lapho khona kwakumele kuthathwe lelundlu leli.
We are in the month of Abib now.
Since kuyo leyo nyanga le.
10th day, make sure every household has a lamb.
Wathi ke iba nesiqinisekiso ukuthi indlu nethi inalo iwundlu.
And the lamb must be without any blame.
40 lelundlu akumele libe nasici.
But on the 14th day,
what am I going to 14?
It is now the day to slaughter.
6.
It says you shall keep it until the 14th day of the same month. Then the whole assembly of the congregation of Israel is to slaughter it at twilight. Are you reading? Or are you interpreting? I'm reading verse 6. So the tenth day, they take the lamb for each household. They wait another 4 days. This is the prophetic instruction for their exodus. And you know we serve a God of instructions. And every time God wants his people to come out, he has to send a prophet and prepare them for that exodus. Remember, this was a season the children of Israel have been waiting for many years. And there were other miraculous events that God had already done through Moses, but they could not be able to break the heart of Pharaoh to let them go.
But
in the prophetic calendar of God, the right time has come. The moment has come for his people to be out of the house of bondage. But the way they need to come out, God has to cause them to go through a process. And this process is very involving. And it has timelines.
That needs cut.
It needs a lot of soberness.
It needs
a lot of alertness, sensitivity. And there is effort involved. So it was not an easy thing. But God wanted them to do it in oneness. And I call it spiritual intelligence. Because the information was coming from God to Moses. And Aaron. And they were in a foreign land. The children of Israel. And in that foreign land, the information they have received, it's not supposed to leak. Only them they were supposed to know that which God has said to
us.
And everyone was expected to keep that secret to himself. So the word was was only specifically for the children of Israel in a foreign land. So we can find, we are living together. This is an Egyptian. An Israelite. An Egyptian. An Israelite. This is a house. But the prophetic word has come.
God, there is this prophet who said figure.
And the intelligence, that spiritual intelligence, it is meant only, the message must only reach the Israelites. Remember, they are already in the prophetic calendar for Exodus. But
their
requirements and their timelines. On the 10th day, take yourself a lamb, everyone. But don't kill it. Wait until the 14th day. And not only the 14th day, but at twilight. Twilight is when the sun is about, in the evening, when the sun now goes, it's about to go down. When that sun is about to go down. That's the twilight.
Yebo.
At that moment,
Nalelothuba,
everybody should take his knife.
Kumele wonke umuntu athathe kummese.
Remember, they are in Egypt.
Kumbona ukuthi baseGibhithe.
They are not in the same place.
Ababekho endaweni eyodwa efanele.
The intelligence have reached all the Israelites.
Kodwa ke nomhlakani ke nalomlayezo usufike wonke umuntu kaIsrayeli.
I think God is a strategist. He's a strategist.
Ngoba uNkulunkulu uNkulunkulu obuhlakani nohlelayo.
He knows how to bring his people to a place where he can make them be in his own strategy. And for them to keep that secret, that intelligence was very key.
They had to
keep it to themselves as Israelites in a foreign land where they knew very well there were enemies around them. But let's jump now from verse, we are in verse what? In verse 6. Let's now jump a little bit and see verse 8. We'll take it slow. We are still in the timelines. And now we're gonna take it. Let's do verse 7.
It says, verse 7.
Moreover, they shall take some of the blood and put it on the two doorposts and on the lintel above the door of the house in which they eat it.
Baza utabata egaz, bali bet, as in zigen zon bid zonyan, na se kota menyan, as in shini, abaya utela uzo.
They shall eat the meat that same night, roasted in fire, and they shall eat it with unleavened bread and bitter herb. This was a 24-hour encounter and a
24-hour
exodus. So God comes and gives them that we are in the prophetic calendar, and in that 14th day, now is the day when everything will take place.
And now we're in the
14th day, they have already killed, every household have killed the land.
And now we see that
God gives them an instruction about the land.
He says,
you shall separate the blood from the meat. And the blood of every lamb. In each household you shall use it to apply upon the
doorpost.
But the meat, you shall roast it in fire. And then you shall take bread. That is unleavened. And heat with bitter herbs. Let me bring it to your attention that everything that God said to them had a prophetic meaning. Everything that God said to them had a prophetic meaning. It symbolized something. For them to, why should God add another diet in terms of the bitter herb and the unleavened bread? We all know that the yeast, the leaven, always, even Jesus when he was on earth, he spoke about the Pharisees and the Sadducees.
And
every time he spoke about it, he was symbolizing or meaning the hypocrisy or insincerity. So by them eating the unleavened bread together with the
lamb,
to me, it seems like it was more of them searching their heart to be sincere and broken before God.
And then
to eat the bitter herbs.
Okay.
Yes. To hit the bitter herb, it was for them to remind themselves of the pain they have gone through.
Because
the Bible says they were bitter, but they had to eat. It's paining, but they had to eat. God wanted them to remind themselves that they should never forget that day. That they need to live to tell their children. So the bitter herb was necessary. The Lord said, let's see the last instruction.
As beginning of life, okay.
Verse 9, it says, do not eat any of it raw or boiled in water, but roasted in fire, both its head and its legs, along with its inner parts.
Ningalidli lisehlaza noma liphekwe nokuphekwa ngamazi, kepha losiwe ngomlilo, ikhanda lalo kanye nemilenze yalo nesibilini zalo.
Then verse 10. This is another last instruction he gave them. He says, you shall let none of the meat remain until the morning. Remember, this was a 24-hour encounter and exodus. And anything that remains left over until morning, you shall burn completely in the fire. Then we shall read only two scriptures.
So from the mouth of some believe.
Verse 13.
So from verse 13
and verse 29.
No, 29.
Then I pray. Verse 13 says, the blood shall be a sign for you on the doorposts of the houses where you live. When I see the blood, I shall possess over you. I shall pass over you, and no affliction shall happen to you to destroy you when I strike the land of
Egypt.
Verse 29. Now it happened at midnight that the Lord struck every firstborn in the land of Egypt, from the firstborn of Pharaoh who sat on his throne to the firstborn of the prisoner who was in the dungeon, and all the firstborn of the cattle.
Kwathi phakathi kwamabili uJehova wabulala onke amazibulo ezwe laseGibhithe, kusukela kulizibulo likaFaro owayehlala esihlalweni sakhe sobukhosi kuze kube yizibulo lesiboshwa esasisisentilongweni kanye namazibulo onke ezinkomo.
Father, I thank you for the reading of your word. I pray that you may anoint my lips to speak your oracles. Thank you for the unction of the Holy Spirit in the house. May you take charge and over and give me the tongue of the learning to speak your oracles. present to you this message entitled this afternoon. One more plague. Give your neighbor a high five, tell him one more plague. You can close your Bible. You don't need a notebook this afternoon. You just need to tighten your belt. You're ready to take off. Let me announce to you before I continue. It is Exodus time. I say it is Exodus time. It is time to leave. I say it is time to leave. You better capture some words. Because those words are going to be very key in this message. I say it is time for Exodus. It is time to leave. Listen to me. The devil has two options. He either leave or you leave. But there must be a pattern. You cannot remain in the house of bondage. You cannot remain in the house of captivity. I want to shake your name and tell him it is Exodus time. This time is in the calendar of God. And you know, don't play with the prophetic calendar.
What? What's that? It's prophet. It's Catholic prophet.
I don't want to take you through the prophetic calendar.
I'm following what you think. And he said, the calendar is prophet.
But how many times, even in the human calendar, we have planned things, but they have never taken place?
What?
In the political calendar, they have planned it, but they have postponed it.
What's the political about anything? What the best thing is?
Tell your neighbor, don't play with the prophetic calendar. It will never be exchanged. It will never be interfered. It will never be affected. When God says it is time, it is time. When God says this is the moment, this is the moment.
It's cut.
I heard the bishop say yesterday. He does the first miracle. Pharaoh is still holding them.
What do Pharaoh do?
He does the second one. Pharaoh is still holding. We're gonna switch it up the other side.
She's going to shake her hand.
This one you will not just do it.
No, they can help us anyway.
This one you must involve everybody.
No, because
it is about revelation. And everybody must catch the revelation. So I have to involve everybody in this miracle. Because I have only one bullet, one more plaque. Let them go. The Lord says to Moses, God tell the children of Israel, in this month of Abib, in the years to come, and in all generations, it is going to
Let every household. Every household. Every household. Touch. Get itself alarmed. Get itself alarmed. And you can see the children of Israel. They are busy, everyone.
You
you sleeping, thinking you are the same as they knew. But when you wake up in the morning, when they open their doors, they will realize you are not the way they thought. There's gonna be a 24-hour intervention. I don't know who I'm talking to, but I declare before 12 o'clock tonight, somebody, there's gonna be a turnaround in your life. Everything that was working against you is gonna work in your favor, because God is telling me to tell you, your Exodus time has come.
God did
not allow any Egyptian to get into. Because I still believe in any Egyptian got the intelligence. The angel will not care about who is inside. Because the Bible says the blood was just to be a sign of the covenant. So when the angel of destruction was coming, now it is twilight. We are talking of about, you know, here in Kenya we are 1 hour ahead. So 6 o'clock in Kenya, 6:30, that is the time now we see the sun going down.
But here
here it's 5:30. So let's use South Africa, let's not use Kenya. So now it's 5:30.
I said that was
they have all killed their lambs. They have applied the blood. They have partook the meat, and they have roasted the meat and everything, and but listen to God. God says to them, after you have prepared everything, you should not think that by tomorrow you will eat the same meal. This is only for 24 hours. That's number one. And number two, you're not gonna eat with your night dress. Make sure you are put on well, because the counting has already begun. And I can see now in your microwave is, you know, I like wrestling sometimes, because, you know, wrestling is amazing. Because before these fighters go to the ring, they will have a changing room, and you'll find them preparing themselves, and they're waiting for the timeline, they're waiting for the moment, and everyone has his song of how it
ends.
And everybody will wait for his time. And they understand about when your moment comes. Even if you are the weakest, you will come in a way that they think you are the strongest. You know why? Because they know that in their moment. And they can see. It is now 6.
So six
again, from 6 to 12, how many hours we have?
Six.
Other hours. You can imagine. Now they are there. Angels are there. They have already been.
So the angel says,
because verse 29 says, at midnight. But if you read about the angels, you realize that their speed is so fast. So I can see them preparing. And they are ready, waiting. Because the prophetic calendar of God can never go wrong.
Moses,
that when the angel will strike,
the
children of Israel will open their doors.
And
God God tell the children, God say to Moses to tell the children of Israel, everybody to stay in his own house. But when they will begin to hear the weeping, because every firstborn of everything is gonna be slaughtered. When they begin to hear the cry, and now we are here in 10 a.m. We are here in 11, 10 p.m. 11 p.m. And now it is 11:30, 11:40, 11:45, 11:50, 11:55, and now we're 11:59. And then the angels
went fast,
and they are there doing what they have been commanded. They come to you and they see there's an Egyptian, they strike. They see the blood, they jump. You can imagine you are just in the midst right there. And you are an Israelite.
Who is my name?
And the next house is an Egyptian.
Which and
the other house here, I know she doesn't want to be an Egyptian, but she's an Egyptian. And then you just hear a cry this side. And you hear a cry this side. And you hear another cry there. And you hear another cry there. What will you do? You will just kneel down and worship. So I can see there are two voices. There is a voice of crying and mourning in Egypt, and there is a voice of Israelite worshiping. Then it goes. It goes to the municipality. It goes. It goes to the ministers. It goes. It goes until it reaches the president. That same angel came in and struck right in Pharaoh's house. And they bring to Pharaoh the son. And they say, even your son.
But
Pharaoh could not take it anymore. Himself.
Yeah, no call.
He made a call.
Was there?
Please call Moses.
But Bizan Moses.
And he said to Moses.
Was it to Moses?
Please.
We are there.
Everything.
Tatani your kingdom.
The sheep.
Tatani Zinvo.
Whatever you want.
Young in the nation.
And please go on and serve yourself.
In better hand, any no comfort for the world.
And when you pray, remember to bless me. Please go. The same one. Who put them in bondage? It's the same one who loosed. I am here to tell you. You are in the prophetic calendar. You have tried it. You have tried business. You have tried to raise your kids in the right direction. But still, it's not happening. You are waiting for the appointed time. Because when the time comes for God to favor you, nothing can stop that which God wants. Three things are going to happen.
That's the thing touching against it.
Number one, God is gonna preserve you. You're gonna see others falling, but you're standing. You shall never be proud. You shall always remember. It is by the grace of God. You shall see the children flourishing. And other children are not flourishing over other families. Never be proud. Always remember the grace of God. Number two. God will command your enemies to let you go.
Which is a cool.
Everything that has helped you.
It
is time for that thing to lose you. Some of you are in serious bondage of debt. But in this Passover, I lose you in Jesus' name. Some of you are in serious bondage of infirmity, a cycle of sickness and disease. But I declare a command from God to lose you from every infirmity and every sickness. And that thing, they never left empty-handed. God gave them favor. God gave them favor. Stand up on your feet. Lift up your hands and worship the Lord. Tell the Lord His exodus time. It is going to be the beginning of the month. It is Exodus time. Somebody is coming out. It's gonna be a Passover. Sickness will pass over. Pain will pass over. Struggles will pass over. Oppression will pass over. Everything the devil was doing in your life, it shall pass over. Father, I thank you for your people. Oh Jesus, release the grace.
Oh,
Just lift your right hand. Father, in Jesus' name, I thank you for your word. I thank you for your people. I pray at this very moment. Some have been waiting for a long time. But I declare, let the exodus begin. In the mighty name of Jesus. If they experience exodus, because the appointed time has come. I declare no more pain, no more struggle in their life. In Jesus' mighty name. Let's give Jesus a mighty hand. So let's give Jesus a mighty hand. Hallelujah. I think before I call the bishop, and maybe we have the Holy Communion and later maybe we pray for the people. Because Bishop, I still feel that there are people in this place who are sick.
Yes, Bishop,
I need to lay hands on them. Declare divine healing in Jesus' name. Whatever your need is, believe this afternoon, God is going to touch you. Yesterday, how many were here? Let me see. Yesterday evening. The Lord spoke to us very powerfully about the marine kingdom. And I want us to do this in oneness. In this Passover conference. Whether they are forces of the earth or of the air or of the sea, they are all under the mastership of Jesus Christ. And Jesus says, greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. So you don't need to fear. But I still believe that when we come into such a season, we must not only come to receive, but we must come to tap into that grace of that season. And there are people in this place who are saying, I'm tired of this level that I'm in. I need God to release the wealth in my hands, that I may use this wealth to serve the Lord. If you read Isaiah chapter 60 verse 5, it says the abundant wealth of the sea shall come to us. And God is willing for his people not to suffer emptiness. How many are tired of living an empty life? We serve a God of more than enough. And is able to increase that which you have. God has never gone bankrupt. And it is the will of God for all of us to be blessed. So I want, in the spirit of thanksgiving, I want you today to make a sacrificial offering. And this sacrificial offering,
sacrifice,
I want you to name it.
Wealth
transfer. Because wealth is in wrong hands. And yet this world is supposed to be in the hands of God's people. And all of us yesterday evening, we took envelopes and we
say
we're
going
to go and pray and come with it on this altar. And there are those who envelopes were not enough, but they say they will get the bishop promised them that they will get the envelope today. But remember the children of Israel, when they did it,
They did what they did. They did in oneness.
Go to kumbu luguti. No kabanda na ba Israel ba wenz. Ba no muye para ba wenz a desang
en. I know life is in levels, but let's unite.
Those
who have more, those who have less before God,
God
so I want, if you are not here, if you were not here,
okay.
Yesterday evening, the pastors are going to give you the envelope. I want the pastors who were here yesterday to come. All of us took envelopes. In the evening, purpose was one. God calls wealth to be transferred to us. Let this be just an unlocking key. It may not be enough what I'm giving to you, but can you use it?
God will service,
and the Lord shall use it. If you are there, you are not there, come for
and
pick this envelope. Come and pick before they finish. Write wealth transfer. Write wealth transfer. We need millionaires in the church. We need international businessmen. We need God to open doors for people. That the vision may not be crippled. Vision needs to run.
Bishop Mela Kitchen.
And for the vision to run, you must be blessed by God. Because it is the will of God. Give your neighbor a pen if he doesn't have.
Nigeza makelona kipeni mengi na.